A work in progress. That's what the vice president says about President Trump's campaign rally in Tulsa. During an interview today, he said different venues were being considered, as well as the idea of holding that rally outside. The Trump campaign said the rally is still happening in the original venue, but another arena are being considered for the overflow. The Oklahoma governor says he's asked the campaign to move that rally to a larger outside venue. And 2 months from tomorrow, the Democratic National Convention is set to begin as the race for the White House plays out amidst the backdrop of everything else going on.
Yeah, Frank, the election is likely to present challenges that states are still trying to figure out. News 5's John Kosick joining us live now. And John, that includes Ohio.
And that's why the state is taking steps right now. They know that even though early voting doesn't start for another 111 days, in many ways, it's underway right now. On social media Monday night, Ohio Secretary of State Frank LaRose tweeted out the good news for Ohio voters that the state's controlling board agreed to mail absentee ballot applications to the state's 7.8 million registered voters, something the state has actually done since 2012. One comment, though, caught his eye.
Well, somebody said, well, why don't you just make Election Day spread out over 4 days so that everybody has the chance to vote and you don't have crowding? And I said, how about a month?
LaRose referring in this week's meeting of the state's Ready for November task force to the month of early in-person voting at your local board of elections and, of course, the month of vote by mail. While both don't start until early October, you actually can apply for a vote by mail ballot now. And OSU election law expert Ned Foley says you should.
We cannot procrastinate with respect to voting this year. This is not the year to wait.
So when the Republican National Committee points to voting by mail disenfranchising voters, Foley said that happens when the states are overrun with requests and can't handle the load like happened in Wisconsin. He puts it this way. Ohioans learned quickly the value of flattening the curve when it came to battling the coronavirus, spread the cases out so as not to overwhelm the hospital system.
In the election law world, we're talking about flattening the absentee ballot curve. Meaning not everybody should apply for an absentee ballot at the last minute, because if you do, you're going to swamp the capacity of your local election workers who are trying their best to meet the demand in what's going to be a high turnout election.
And that was an issue, you'll recall, in the Ohio primary back in April. We had all those applications coming in at the last minute. Now, another issue they're going to be dealing with: poll workers. We need 35,000 of them here in the state of Ohio. Many of them are older workers, retirees, who aren't feeling comfortable in returning to the polls, so that when you get that vote by mail application, there's going to be an extra slot on there to ask you if you yourself are interested this November in being a poll worker.
Okay, so John, how does Ohio stack up against other states?
Here's the thing. Back in November of 2004, we were kind of a laughingstock for the way we were handling that particular year's election. And what followed were 16 years of solid reforms. And as a result, it's put us in a position where we are much better off than many other states right now. But the bottom line is we saw the problems that we had in the primary with those late absentee ballots coming in. And that's something they're trying to address by getting people to apply for those ballots earlier.